Hello guys, welcome to Bhavna's Online Academy. So this is the second part of AS19 leases. The first part has been already uploaded. I'll link it in the description box below. So please watch that first and then continue with this video. So yes guys, today's video we are going to start with the same topic. So the finance lease, in the last video we had seen in the books of lessee. So in this video we are going to see the books of lesser. Okay. Yes, just give me a moment. Yes. So, finance lease, books of lesser. Okay, fine. Yes. So, in lesser, what is the, what do you say, journal entry? First journal entry is that the first journal entry is lessee account debit. Okay, the first journal entry is lessee account debit to asset or sale account. Okay. So, mostly you will write to asset account only. Okay, fine. So, to asset account, because you have given the asset to the you have given the asset to the other person, that is the lessee. So lessee has been debited. Since you have given your asset away, it's getting credited. Okay, so lessee account debit to asset account, the same opposite entry for what we did in lesser. In lesser we did asset account debit to lessor. In lessee's books we did asset account debit to lessor. In lessor's book we are going to do lessee account debit to asset account, the opposite entry. Okay, so here now the next doubt is, what is the value that you are going to write here? So the next doubt is, what is the value that you are going to write here? So here the value that you are going to write is the net investment. It is the net investment. Okay, so how do we find out net investment or the value of net investment? You can find out the value of net investment by doing present value of gross investment. You can find out net investment by doing present value of gross investment. So suppose gross investment is 1 lakh rupees, you have to do the present value of 1 lakh or the present value of gross investment, and whatever net investment you get or the value you get, that is the value that you are going to write here. Okay, fine. So now let's understand what is the procedure or how do we find gross investments, because if we find gross investments then it's easy. You have to just find the present value of it and you'll get the answer. Okay. So how do you find out gross investments? Yes, so it's written here, the formula of gross investment or gross payment you may call lease rental. Lease rental is means the rent that you are going to get from the lessee. The rent that the lessor is going to get from the lessee yearly, that lease rental you have to write here. Number one. Okay. Then you have to add, then you will add guaranteed residual value of lessor. Guaranteed residual value of lessor. Okay, so in the, okay, so now I'll not talk about the last case, but here anyway I'll just give you a reference so you don't get confused. Here the guaranteed residual value was by the lessee or on his behalf. So this is different and this one is different. Here the guaranteed residual value is of lessor. Lessor, lessor, in the books of lessor means you have to take guaranteed residual value of lessor only. So how you will find the guaranteed residual value of lessor is that you have to do higher of guaranteed residual value by lessee. Guaranteed residual value by lessee, how will you find out? It will be given in the question. Or guaranteed residual value by any third party, either by lessee or any other third party. So higher of whatever the guaranteed residual value is, that you have to take. Suppose the lessee tells the lessor that by the end of lease period, after the lease term is over, I will give you 30,000 for this asset. And suppose there is some third party, some other person, okay? And he is coming and telling to the lessor that for this asset, by the end of lease term, after the lease term gets over, I'll give you around 50,000 rupees. Then here what you have to do is, you have to compare these both. Whichever is higher, you have to take here. Suppose 50,000 is higher means, you have to take guaranteed residual value by lessor is 50,000. So you have to compare between these both. Then plus, you have to do unguaranteed residual value. Unguaranteed residual value. So this is what you have to do to find out your gross payment. So lease rental plus guaranteed residual value by lessor, that you know how to find out higher of guaranteed residual value by lessee or guaranteed residual value by any third party. Okay, I hope this is clear to you, how you have to find out your gross payments. Okay, so in this gross payments formula itself, there are two more formulas that are hidden. There are two more formulas there that are hidden here. Okay, so what are those two more formulas? I'll tell you. Okay, now suppose if you do Now suppose if you take only guaranteed residual value of lesser plus unguaranteed residual value, if you take only guaranteed residual value of lesser and unguaranteed residual value, you will get residual value. So in case in the question only residual value is given and unguaranteed residual value is given, that in such case you know how to find out the guaranteed residual value. You have to do nothing but residual value minus unguaranteed will give you guaranteed. So remember this, guaranteed plus unguaranteed will give you residual value. Okay, fine. This is one formula. The other formula that is hidden here is that lease rental plus unguaranteed residual value by lessor. Lease rental plus guaranteed residual value of lessor will give you minimum lease payment from the point of view of lessor. It will give you minimum lease payment from the point of view of lessor. So these are the three formulas. Okay. So I hope there is no confusion with this. Yes. So now let's start with the sum here. Okay, so in the sum, they would have actually asked you to find out unearned finance income. Okay, unearned finance income, they would have told to find out. How do you find out unearned finance income? Gross investment minus net investment, if you do, you will get your unearned finance income. Okay, yes. So now let's start with the question. Okay, Prakash Limited leads the mission to Badal Limited on the following terms. Okay. So, fair value of the mission was 48 lakhs. Lease term was 5 years. Lease rental per annum was 8 lakhs. Guaranteed residual value is 1,60,000. Expected residual value. See, this only I told you. Residual value alone, if they give, this means there is guaranteed also, there is unguaranteed also. So, it is 3 lakh rupees. Okay. So, in such case, you here in the question, unguaranteed is not given. So, how do you find out unguaranteed? If guaranteed is 1,60,000 and the total is 3 lakh. So, what you have to do? You have to do 3 lakh minus 1,60,000 and you will get your unguaranteed residual value. Okay. Okay. I just got my calculator. We'll calculate. So, unguaranteed residual value is 3 lakh minus 1,60,000. So, 1,40,000 is your this unguaranteed residual value. Okay. Internal rate of return is 15%. 15%, you know how, what, for what you will use this internal rate of return. You will use it to discount from present value to future value. I mean, for future value to present value. Okay. And the discounting rates they have given you here, they have told you to ascertain unearned finance income. Okay, unearned finance income, how will you find out? Gross investment minus net investment you have to do. Okay, so first thing, what is net investment? Net investment is nothing but present value of gross investment. Present value of gross investment. So in this question, you have to first find out gross investment so that you are able to find out the answer. Okay, so gross investments, let's find out. So what is gross investment? What is the formula? The formula is lease rental plus guaranteed residual value of lessor plus unguaranteed residual value. Okay, so here this only they have given. See, lease rental plus guaranteed residual value plus unguaranteed residual value. So what is the total lease rent? Lease rental, what is the total? So it is per annum, it is 8 lakh. Okay, into 5 years they have done. So that they are able to find out total lease rent. Okay, into lease term they have did. So 8 lakh into 5 years they have did here, which will come up to around 40 lakhs. Okay, so this is one thing. And the next component is guaranteed residual value. So guaranteed residual value they have given directly in the question, which is 1,60,000. Okay, plus what you have to do? Unguaranteed residual value, which we found out, which was 1,40,000, right? So plus 1,40,000, which is 43 lakh rupees. So 43 lakh rupees is your gross investment. So you have to find out unearned finance income. Unearned finance income. Okay. So gross investment is 43 lakh. You have to do gross investment minus net investment. Net investment is nothing but present value of gross investment. So first now you have to find out present value. So how do you find out present value? So here you have written year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here you have written all the minimum lease payment inclusive of URV. What you have written? Minimum lease payment inclusive of URV, because the total gross investment, that is for 43 lakhs wholly, for this whole 43 lakhs, here you have to find out the present value. So you have to write it all. Okay. So 8 lakh all the lease rentals for 5 years, and then in the 5th year you will also get your gross residual value and guaranteed residual value and unguaranteed residual value. So all both are written. So all the lease payments, that is 8 lakh, 8 lakh, 8 lakh, 8 lakh, 8 lakh for 5 years. Then guaranteed residual value 1,60,000 and unguaranteed residual value 1,40,000, which comes up to a total of 43 lakh. So now this you have to discount to get the present value. So how do you discount it? Discount at the at 15%, because in the question they had given you internal rate of return is 15%. So when you discount it, you get a present value of gross investment as 28,30,920. You get 28,30,920. This is your present value of gross investments. So easy. Unearned finance income is 43 lakh minus 28,30,000, which is 14,69,080. Okay. So this is how you find out your unearned finance income. I hope this is clear. And also, if in the question they tell you to write the journal entry, then in such case, in this first journal entry, lessee account debit to asset account, what will you write? You have to write your net investment. So your net investment is 28,30,920. So what you will do, you will come here and you will write 28,30,920. You will write here and here. Okay. So I hope this is also clear. So that was all about finance lease. So we have seen all the concepts, the 5 conditions, books of lessee and books of lessor. So everything we have seen in relation to finance lease. So the next topic that comes is operating lease. So in operating lease, I first started with giving you the difference between finance lease and operating lease. So in finance lease and operating lease, what is the difference? First, we'll start with lessor. In finance lease, the lessor books it like a sale. Okay. And he will not charge the depreciation for the asset. Whereas in finance lease, the lessee is going to charge the depreciation and he will record it as a purchase. Now let's come to operating lease. In operating lease, the lessor will record it as a rental income and he will only charge the depreciation for the asset. The lessee will record it as a rental expense and he or she will not book the depreciation. Okay, because here in finance lease, what the concept is it is just like a sale. So if the asset has been sold to lessee, that means it is his asset. He should only do the depreciation for it also, or book the depreciation for it also. It's the same hire purchase concept. Whereas in terms of operating lease, this is just like a rent. So in rent, the asset is not of lessee. The asset is of the owner or the lessor only. So he will only book the depreciation here and the lessee will not book the depreciation here. Okay, so this is the difference between finance lease and operating lease. Okay. So now the lessor or lessee, whoever it is, how will they record this rental income or rental expense? How will they record this rental income or rental expense? So here it is written, see, you have to record it in the ratio of benefits derived. You have to record it in the ratio of benefits derived. What does it mean that we have to record it in the ratio of benefits derived means? If you see this question, you will be able to understand. See, suppose outputs from a machine of economic life 6 years are estimated as 10,000 in year 1, 20,000 in year 2, 30,000 in year 3, 40,000 in year 4, 20,000 in year 5 and 55,000 in year 6. Okay, so here what they tell is there is a machine and the economic life of the machine is 6 years. Okay, and if you use this machine for 6 years, this is how you are going to get your produce. In the first year, you will get 10,000 units. In second year, you will get 20,000. And in year 6, you will get 5,000. Okay. So, this is how you are going to get the benefits from the machine. This is how the machine is going to help you produce. The machine was given on a 3-year operating lease. So, this machine was only given on a 3-year operating lease. Okay. By the dealer of the machine. for equal annual lease rentals, for equal annual lease rentals to yield 20% profit margin on cost of 5 lakh. Okay, straight line depreciation is in proportion of output is considered appropriate. Okay, so now let's break the question first. Okay, so first see here. So the total units that are produced in the 6 years are 125 units, 125,000 units. How did I find out 125,000 units? 10,000 in year 1 plus 20,000 in year 2 plus 30,000 in year 3 plus 40,000 in year 4 plus 20,000 in year 5 plus 5,000 in year 6. So if you add all of these 6 years production, you will get to know that the total units that are produced in 6 years is 125,000 units. Okay. The units that is produced in the lease period, how much is the lease period? The lease period is 3 years. Okay. So the units that is produced in the lease period is 60,000 units. How did I arrive at 60,000 units? In year 1, it was 10,000. In year 2, it was 20,000. And in year 3, it was 30,000. So 60,000 units is what produced in the lease period. Okay. So now what we are going to do is that in the end, we have to find out what is the lease rent. Okay. So in this question, they have asked you to actually calculate the lease rent. Per year or per annum, we may say, whatever. Okay. So now you have to first find out total lease rent. Then only you'll be able to find out per annum, correct? So the total lease rent, here what they have told you is the total lease rent. Wait. Okay. Here they have told you that the lease rent is equal annual lease rentals to yield 20% profit margin on cost 5 lakh rupees. On cost 5 lakh, if it is 20% profit margin, means what is the amount? 5 lakh plus 20% profit. What is the amount that you get here? Find that out. Plus 20%. Okay, 6 lakh is the total value that you get. 6 lakh is the total value that you get. Okay, so 6 lakh is the total value that you get. Okay, fine. So, now, what we are going to do is that to find out our per annum lease rent, here they have told you that you have to record your rental income or rental expense. That is nothing but your lease rent or lease income in the ratio of benefits delivered. That if in the first year you got 10,000, in second year you got 20,000, in the third year you have got 30,000. So according to that only you have to record your benefits. So what you have told us, so now here what they have done is that, what is this 6 lakh rupees? The 6 lakh rupees is the total benefit that you have got, total benefit that you will get by producing all the 125,000 units. This is the total benefit that you will get by producing the 125,000 units. So 6 lakh rupees is the benefit that you are going to get if you produce 125,000 units, okay. So now to find out the lease rent, you have to find out how much benefit will you get from producing 60,000 units. So in that 6 lakh, how much is pertaining to 60,000 units? So 6 lakh into 60,000 by 125,000 units, which is 2,88,000 rupees. So that your total lease rent is going to be 2,88,000. So your total lease rent is going to be 2,88,000. Okay. So annual lease rent will be nothing but 2,88,000 divided by 3, which is 96,000. So annual lease rent is going to be nothing but 2,88,000 by 3, which is 96,000. Here, one concept which you have to understand is that you paying of lease rent is not related to recording of lease rent. Every year you may pay a lease rent of 96,000, 96,000 and 96,000 for 3 years. See, here we have found out, right? Annual lease rent. Every year you may pay lease rent of 96,000, 96,000 and 96,000, but is not. But it is not important that in the first year itself you record 96,000. You are paying and you are recording it in the books are both different. Here, how you should recognize this is, you have to recognize the income in the proportion of output only. Here, the proportion of output is 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. So, the proportion is 1 is to 2 is to 3. So, this 2,88,000, even though yearly you are paying 96,96,96,000, you must record it in the books only in the form of 1:2:3, whether it is lessee's books or lessor's book. You have to record it in this proportion only. So when you do so, 2,88,000 in the ratio of 1:2:3, in the first year you are going to record 48,000, in second year you will record 96,000, and in the third year you will record 1,44,000. The total for both will be 2,88,000 only, but the payment and recording is different. Okay, and the depreciation, so here, one minute. So the depreciation is also in the proportion of output only. So in the proportion of output only, your depreciation will also be charged. Okay. So here the depreciable amount of the asset will be 5 lakh rupees, because it is not 6 lakh, because the 20%, that is the 1 lakh rupees, is profit only. So profit you will never depreciate, correct? Only the asset value you will depreciate. So here the asset value was 5 lakh. So 5 lakh rupees you will depreciate over the life of 6 years. According to the output proportionally, which is 1:2:3:4:2:5. And in the first year, the depreciation amount is 40,000, and it will go so on. So I hope this concept of operating lease is also clear to you. Okay, so now we have come towards our last concept. And the last concept here is sale and lease back. The last concept here is sale and lease back. So we have completed financing lease, we have completed operating lease, and the last concept here is sale and lease back. So, sale and lease back is also like a concept of operating lease only. Okay. So, here what happens is that there is a lessee and there is lessor. Okay. So, this one is easier to understand. Okay. So, this is seller and this is the buyer. So, what happens is the seller sells his asset to the buyer. The seller sells his asset to the buyer. Okay. Then, what happens is that after some time, the buyer, he gives the asset to lease on the seller itself. He gives the asset to lease on seller itself. So here then, in such case, what happens? The buyer will become the lessor, because now he is the owner of the asset and he have given the same asset on lease to the lessee now. Lessee will be the seller. So here, as you can see, there is a seller. There is a seller. He sells his truck. We can say he sells his truck to the buyer. He sells his truck to the buyer. The seller sells his truck to the buyer. Now what happens? The buyer is going to give the same truck on lease. Same truck on lease to the seller. So here the buyer becomes the lessor and the seller becomes the lessee. So this is nothing but this concept is known as lease back. That means the person who have sold you the asset, he himself is getting it on lease from you. So this concept is known as lease back. Okay. So here, as you can see, sale and lease back. This is the concept name, sale and lease back. Okay, fine. Yes. So now in this concept, what you are going to do, very simple concept only, but questions are being asked in the exam from this. Okay, fine. So what will happen is they will give you a case. Case means nothing, question 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. You might have a few questions. The carrying amount or the book value of the asset, they will give you in the question. The fair value of the asset will also be given in the question, and the sale price of the asset will also be given in the question. So three parts will be given: carrying amount, fair value, sale price. Okay, so these will all be given in the question. From this three components, you have to identify three things. First thing that you have to identify is impairment loss. Okay. So if we number carrying amount as 1, fair value as 2, and sale price as 3, then impairment loss will be numbered as 4. So how will you find out impairment loss is that you will do 1 minus 2. Here 1 minus 2 means carrying amount minus fair value. You will do, and you will find out impairment loss. Okay. So now here what you have to remember is you have to only do 1 minus 2 and the answer must always be positive. In the case the answer is positive, you have to write here. Okay. Suppose you are doing 40 lakh minus 35 lakh, then in such case, the answer will be 5 lakh rupees. The answer will be 5 lakh rupees, right? So this is a positive answer. So in such case only you have to book, you have to write it as impairment loss. That is only when carrying amount is more than fair value, you have to write an impairment loss. Otherwise, you don't write it here. Leave it as a blank. Next is deferred income. Next is deferred income. So deferred income, we can number it as number 5. So how do you find out deferred income is that you do 3 minus 2. You do 3 minus 2. That means you do sale price minus fair value. You are going to do sale price minus fair value. This also only in the case your answer is positive, you have to write here. In case it is negative, don't write here. Then in such case, your sale price must be greater than fair value. Then only you will be able to write it as deferred income. Suppose, see, 3 minus 2, right? See, sale value is 50 lakh. Fair value is 46 lakh. So if you do 50 lakh minus 46 lakh, you will get it as 4 lakh rupees. So in such case, only you have to write it as a deferred income or leave the space blank. Third is the difference. So difference means you can number it as number 6. And this how you will find out, you will do 1 versus 3. You will do 1 versus 3. What is 1? 1 is your carrying amount. What is 3? 3 is your sale price. So you have to do 1 versus 3. And whatever the difference is there, you have to write here. Suppose, if you see here, here 1 is carrying amount of 40 lakh rupees. And the sale price is 50 lakh rupees. Carrying amount is 40 lakh. Sale price is 50 lakh rupees. Okay. Here, when you do 1 versus 3, here only 6 lakh rupees is written. Why is 6 lakh rupees written? Because here between 1 and 3, how much is the difference? 50 lakh and 40 lakh, how much is the difference? 10 lakh rupees is the difference. 10 lakh rupees is the difference. Now, what you have to see is whether from this 10 lakh, already is it booked as impairment loss or deferred income, you have to see. If from this 10 lakh, already impairment loss or deferred income is booked or not, you have to see. Here, already 4 lakh rupees has been booked. So, only the remaining you have to book in the difference. That is, in 10 lakh, what is the difference? 4 lakh is already been booked. So, the remaining 6 lakh alone, if you book, it is enough. Okay, so I'll repeat this alone here again. So 1 and 3 you have to compare for the difference, and now suppose the difference is 10 lakh rupees. That means you have to see if already anything has been accounted as impairment loss or deferred income. Here a deferred impairment loss nothing has been accounted, but as deferred income 4 lakh has already been accounted. So the remaining value from 10 lakh is 6 lakh rupees. So that alone if you record as difference, it is enough. Okay, so I hope this all is clear. How you have to find impairment loss, deferred income and difference. Okay, so now one more thing that you have to understand is in the question, they will tell you to find out. Okay, so you will be able to find out impairment loss, deferred income and difference. And after finding out all these three things, you have to also write a statement and come. You have to also write a statement and come. In case if you get impairment loss, in such case you have to write this 5 lakh. Suppose you have got 5 lakh impairment loss, then in such case you have to write a sentence to be recognized immediately. To be recognized immediately you have to write. The same in case also you get some difference. Suppose your 6 lakh rupees difference has been got, you have to write to be recognized immediately. To be recognized immediately. Here in the difference, you may either get profit or loss. Like I told you, in impairment loss, it must only be positive, and in deferred income also, it must only be positive. That is, only profit must be there. But in difference, profit or loss might be there. And then deferred income, if you get deferred income, here you have got 4 lakh rupees deferred income. In such case, you will write to be deferred over lease period. To be deferred over lease period. So these three you remember, either impairment loss or difference, write recognize immediately. But in case of deferred income alone, right, to be deferred over the lease period. Okay, fine. So now let's solve one question, and with this our AS 19 will also be over. Okay. So A Limited sold machinery having WDV of 40 lakhs to B Limited. WDV of 40 lakhs to B Limited here means WDV here means book value. WDV here means book value. Book value means nothing but your carrying amount. So the first component here, carrying amount is there, you know, that is only 40 lakhs to B Limited for 50 lakh rupees. So he has sold it for 50 lakh rupees. Then here sale price will be 50 lakh. Here sale price will be 50 lakh. And the same machinery was leased back by B Limited to A Limited. The lease back is operating expense, operating lease. Okay. Comment if. So now we have to comment. Okay. So I have done nothing. I have already written down the answer here. So first case I have written. So totally there are 6 cases. So I have written case A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. Here then in the question itself, they have told you that your carrying amount is going to be 40 lakh rupees. Here they have told you 40 lakhs. So in all cases, 40 lakhs I have written 40, 40, 40, 40, 40 lakhs. Okay. And they have also told you that your sale price is going to be 50 lakh rupees. And sale price is going to be 50 lakh rupees. So 50 lakh, 50 lakh, 50 lakh, 50 lakh. But in 2 cases alone, I have not written 50 lakhs. Why? Because in the question, they have changed and told that sale price is 38 lakh, sale price is 39 lakh. So like this, if in the question, if they have changed and given for specific cases alone, if they have changed and given, that alone I have changed as 38 lakh and 39 lakh. Okay. So sale price also clear. Now let's start reading the question. First A is sale price of 50 lakh is equal to fair value. So sale price is 50 lakh and the fair value is equal to it. Then in such case, fair value will also be 50 lakh rupees. Okay. So until this, you are clear. So now we have to find out impairment loss. So now we have to find out impairment loss. So impairment loss, how will you find out? 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 is carrying amount minus fair value. If you do carrying amount minus fair value, it is 40 lakh minus 50 lakh. If you do 40 lakh minus 50 lakh, what is the answer? Minus 10 lakh. So in such case, what you are going to do is you are going to ignore this. You are going to ignore this. Only if your carrying amount is greater than fair value, you will do it. You have to find out the difference between 1 and 2. Okay. And only if your carrying amount is greater than fair value, you will have to take that. Here carrying amount is less than fair value, so you will not write anything. Next is deferred income. Deferred income, you have to do 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is sale price minus fair value. Here sale price also 50, fair value also 50. So no difference at all. So 0. Okay. Final difference you have to see. 1 versus 3. Here 1 is 40 lakh. 3 is 50 lakh. Here 1 is 40 lakh. 3 is 50 lakh. So what is the difference? So the difference is 10 lakh rupees. So now what you have to write as a comment is that I already told you. If difference is there 10 lakh, then you have to write it as to be recognized immediately. That only they have also written. See, when sales price of 50 lakh is equal to fair value, the same line from the question they have copied and they have written, A Limited should immediately recognize the profit of 10 lakh in its books. Definitely, immediately recognize the profit of 10 lakh in its book. Why they have told it as a profit here? Because they have sold it at 50 lakh rupees, but the carrying amount was only 40 lakh. They have sold it at 50 lakh, but the carrying amount was only 40 lakh. So 10 lakh rupees, there is a difference when they have made the sale. When they have made the sale, 10 lakh rupees profit was there. So that profit 10 lakh rupees they have told here, and they have told that you have to recognize it immediately. So like this only you have to write a sentence in the exam. In the exam for the table and all, there is no marks. For the sentence you write only, there is marks. So sentences are very important. Okay. Case B is fair value is 60 lakh. So fair value 60 lakh. Okay. Other information is already there. So first impairment loss. You have to see 1 minus 2. So 40 lakh minus 60 lakh. If you do, what will happen? You will get minus 20 lakh. So since it is negative, you are not going to write it. Deferred income 3 minus 2. So 3 is sale price minus fair value. Sale price minus fair value is 50 lakh minus 60 lakh. Again, it is minus 10 lakh. So deferred income also you will not write. Finally, difference. Difference will be 1 versus 3. So 1 versus 3 means 50 lakh versus 40 lakh. So 10 lakh rupees here also you have profit as sale price is higher than book value. So the same sentence you can write here. When fair value is 60 lakh, then also profit of 10 lakh should be immediately recognized by A Limited. So whenever you get difference, you have to write it as immediately recognized. Okay. Case number C. Fair value is 45 lakh, sale price is 38 lakh. Okay. Fair value is 45 lakh and sale price 38 lakh. In book value, there it is already there. Again, see impairment loss. So impairment loss is 1 minus 2. That is carrying amount minus fair value. It is 40 lakh minus 45 lakh. Again, you will get minus 5 lakh only. So impairment loss, you cannot write. Deferred income. Deferred income is 3 minus 2. it is 38 lakh minus 45 lakh. So in such case also what you will get? You will get it as minus 7 lakhs. So here that also you cannot write. So deferred income also you cannot write. Finally, difference. So difference is 1 versus 3. So it is carrying amount versus sale price, which is 38 lakh versus 40 lakh. So here you get a difference of 2 lakh, but whether the 2 lakh is the profit or loss, you have to see. Here the sale price is lesser than carrying amount or book value. So 2 lakh is your loss. So minus 2 lakh is your loss. So here in difference, whether it is loss or profit, you have to write. Okay. Yes. So here the same question line you can copy paste. When fair value is 45 lakh and sale price is 38 lakh, then the loss of 2 lakh should be immediately recognized by A Limited in its book, provided loss is not compensated by future lease payment. That and all you can write. Okay. Next, case number D. D. Fair value is 40 lakhs and sale price is 50 lakhs. So fair value is 40 lakhs, sale price is 50 lakhs. So first find out impairment loss. 1 minus 2. So it is 40 lakh minus 40 lakhs, 0. So no need to write. Deferred income. Deferred income is 3 minus 2. So it is 50 lakh minus 40 lakh. So this is positive 10 lakh only. So you can write it as 10 lakh here. Okay, deferred income. Then difference. Difference is 1 versus 3. So it is 40 lakh versus 50 lakh. So your sale price is more and carrying amount is less. So 10 lakh rupees you will get profit, but already the profit, the 10 lakh you have recorded it as deferred income. Okay, so you no need to write it in the difference. Okay, so here in deferred income, what you will write? You will have to defer it over the lease period, right? That was the statement you have to use. So in fair value is 40 lakh and sale price is 50 lakh, then profit of 10 lakhs is to be deferred and amortized over the lease period. Okay, next case number E. Fair value is 46 lakh, sale price is 50 lakh. For a fair value 46 lakh, sale value 50 lakh. So here impairment loss is 1 minus 2. So it is 40 lakh minus 40 lakh minus 46 lakhs. So it is going to be minus 6 lakhs. So that you cannot write. Deferred income is 3 minus 2, which is 50 lakh minus 46 lakh. It is 4 lakh rupees. Very good. It's in positive only. So you can write here 4 lakh. Okay. Now difference. Difference is going to be 1 versus 3, which is 40 lakh versus 50 lakh. So here 40 lakh, 50 lakh means 10 lakh difference. Whether the 10 lakh difference is profit or loss, yes, sale price is higher than carrying amount. So it is profit. So 10 lakh rupees profit. So here what happens? Already 4 lakh rupees profit you have booked. So remaining 3 lakh, same, remaining 6 lakh alone, if you book, it is enough. So this 4 lakh shall be deferred and amortized, whereas this 6 lakh should be immediately recorded. See. When fair value is 46 lakh and sale price is 50 lakh, profit of 6 lakh should be immediately recognized. And the balance profit of 4 lakh shall be amortized and deferred over lease period. Sorry. Okay. Final case. Fair value is 35 lakh, sale price is 39 lakh. Fair value 35 lakh, sale value 39 lakh. Here you have to again see impairment loss 1 minus 2. So 40 lakh minus 35 lakh, 5 lakh rupees is positive. So you can write it here. Then deferred income. So deferred income is 3 minus 2. So it is 39 lakh minus 35 lakh. So 4 lakh profit again. Then finally difference is 1 versus 3. So it is 40 lakh versus 39 lakh. So 40 lakh versus 39 lakh. Here you have got. Yeah. So here 40 lakh versus 39 lakh. Here you get a loss of 1 lakh. Loss of 1 lakh as sale value is lesser than carrying amount. Okay, fine. So now here what you are going to do is that so here this loss of 1 lakh, whether you have to write here or not, here see impairment loss. Impairment loss they have told you. So this is 5 lakh rupees loss already. Then here you have income, that is profit of 4 lakh. So if you do loss minus profit, that is 5 lakh minus 4 lakh, already 1 lakh loss is your net. And this 1 lakh loss you have already booked. This means this 1 lakh loss you have already booked to impairment loss and deferred income. Okay, so that's it. Here you don't need to write any difference. So fair value is 35 lakh, sale price is 39 lakh, loss of 5 lakhs has been immediately recognized and profit of 4 lakhs has been amortized and deferred over lease period. Okay. So I hope all your concepts of AS19 has been clear. If you have any doubts, you can post it in the comment section below. I'll try to solve it as soon as possible. So this was all about AS19. And I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please do like, share, and also subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to leave a comment down below. Thank you so much, guys.